international brigades were formed. And eventually about 50,000 volunteers went to fight for Republican Spain against the fascist rays of Franco. The Irishmen wanted to join that. Most of them were ex-IRA. It was about 160 volunteers went to fight in the international brigades. And 60 of those were killed in Spain. And Frank Graham eventually died in Germany. He was the commander of the Irish contingent in the international brigades. The international brigades were formed into six brigades from the 10th to the 15th. And the 15th brigade was the brigade, the British brigade. And in that they had the American Lincolns, the Canadian Mackenzies, a Latin American group, and the British group. The Irish contingent eventually were formed under the British group, all English speaking, and they took the name of the Connolly Column. And Frank Ryan was the man in charge. To understand why they went at all, we have to go back now and look at Ireland. And I don't want to go too far, I'm not an historian, but in the lockout of 13, when the fascists and the big business consolidated down Martin Murphy and the Confederation of Businessmen in Dublin, when they attacked the workers on the lockout, the press and the church, and especially the church, supported these big businessmen to put down people who didn't earn enough to feed their kids. And Jim Larkin and Connolly were the mainstays of that lockout. And the workers of Liverpool, as you know, supported the workers in Dublin. But the lines were drawn clearly within the country on a left-right axis. And the accusation that everybody who went on strike was a communist was played to the hilt by every bishop, every archbishop and a cardinal in this country. Even Cardinal McCrory, who we would have sometimes a soft spot for, was vicious in his condemnation of the Irish working class who stood up to fight for their rights. There's where the lines were drawn in 1813, and those lines were compounded in 1816 at the Rising, where the press, once again, the Independent and the Times and the Catholic Church actually called the execution of its leaders. And when Connolly was the only one left, the Times still called for his execution. And that's why he was executed in a chair. They weren't satisfied that the revisionists who claimed that 1816 was a criminal conspiracy by a bunch of lunatics, that Patrick Pearse was insane, that Connolly was a communist, they played the anti-communist card, and the anti-communist card, which was a complete lie, became de facto politics in this country, and it infiltrated even the ranks of the Republican struggle. And in 1932, when De Valera won the election, at that time, O'Duffy had been appointed Minister of Police in this country by the Cosgrave government. And to say that there was a split in the Republican ranks would be probably maybe too hard. There were certainly factions within the Republican struggle. For example, the Protestant contingent who went to Bodenstown in 1934 were attacked by the very right wing of the Republican struggle at Bodenstown. The banner that they carried was for the Workers' Republic and down with capitalism. And IRA volunteers at that time tried to rip the banner off them. One of the men who was on that march was Liam Tomlinson, who was a Protestant from this city, who eventually went to fight the International Brigades and was killed in Spain. So you can see that the big enemies of or the Republican struggle at that time weren't just the British imperial forces, but they were the Catholic Church and big business who coalesced against mythical communism and got anybody concerned with the working class got them a dirty name.